Laura
and Haley, back from testing, and coming up for you on the show today is the Trivia Thursday question, an update for speech, and this week's Red Storm results, and much more. So stay where you are, we'll be back in a few seconds.
Do you think that there is something that has room for improvement with the show? Be sure to tell us what you want, because this is your show too. And we're trying to make this show better and fun for all you guys and anyone else who watches. So if you have something to say, please contact us at ptv2@plymouth.k12.in.s or tweet us at LJHDigitalStorm.
Attention, all 8th graders, the Washington, D.C. Trip Parent Meeting is next Monday night. The meeting will be held October 6th in the auditorium. It's okay if you can't go to the meeting, but just know, space is limited. The first ones to sign up are the first ones to go.
This Saturday, the Plymouth Music Boosters will be hosting 14 high school marching bands for the 16th annual Harvest Festival of the Bands Marching Band Competition. The entire Plymouth High School campus will be overflowing with activity. All evening, the teachers should use some adult volunteers to help run stopwatches in the warm-up areas. This is a very easy job, and you get to hear all of the schools warming up. They also need adult help in the stadium, serving as timers and gate monitors to assist with the bands, and cheering and exciting the field. If you can volunteer Saturday evening from approximately 5 to 9, that'd be great.
Have you ever felt the weight of the world on your shoulders? How about just everyone's on your back? You know what? You're not alone, and you don't have to go through it alone. Today in Studio B, we're honored to have a special guest to talk with us about some of these curveballs life throws at us sometimes. Let PTV2 welcome Mrs. Jeffers.
Hi, everybody. It's so exciting to be here during your news show, so thanks so much for having me. The Indiana state law requires that you guys get instructions on the anti-bullying law. So this is what we're going to talk about this morning. I'm going to read the law to you because this is what's required, and then I'll let you know a few things about bullying and what we can all do to stop it. The law says that bullying is defined as unwanted, repeated, intentional acts or gestures, including verbal or written communication or images transmitted in any manner, physical acts committed, aggression, or any behaviors committed by a student or a group of students against another student, with the intent to harass, ridicule, humiliate, intimidate, and harm the targeted student, and create for the targeted student a hostile school environment. That's what bullying does. It creates such a toxic environment at school that kids don't even want to come to school anymore. So we all need to be alert. We all need to be aware of what's happening around us. If you see bullying happening here, if you're being a victim of bullying, you need to report. That's what the state of Indiana expects of all of us. So please report. Don't be afraid of telling someone if you see that it's happening. Report is not tattling. Report is helping the school, the administrators, to find a solution for all of us. We want everybody to feel safe in all the schools in Plymouth. So you can report anonymously. You can send emails to your principals or the administrators of the school, the staff. You can talk to a teacher. You can talk to your counselors. There's so many ways that you can do this by reporting. Because, you know, the real thing about bullying is being an upstander. The people that have the most power in the school when it comes to bullying is the upstanders. Being a bystander only means that you're giving more power to the bully. So please think about that. Become an upstander and help us end this behavior that can really be devastating for everybody. And I would love to have you guys come and join Connect this year. I'm back with the program in all the buildings in Plymouth. I know that many of you have been through Connect if you're coming from Riverside this year, but everybody's welcome to join. So if you're new to the school, please join Connect. And if you have been through Connect before, you're welcome to come back. All you have to do is go and visit Mrs. Stauffer's office and join the program. So I hope you guys have a great day. I hope this has been helpful. Remember, bullying is not allowed, and I need you all to join and come on board on this fight against bullying. Thanks so much for having me here this morning. You guys have a great day.
Thanks for coming in today, Ms. Jeffers. You've given us some great information and shed some light on the problem. I don't think it's discussed often enough. Please come back and visit us again soon.
For speech team members, please make sure you're looking at both the team bulletin board and your Google Docs regularly to make sure there's no practice changes or team news. There's still several team members who have not paid their team dues, and t-shirts need to be ordered. So Mrs. McKenzie needs to know as soon as possible.
Okay, so usually when you think about the corner, you think trouble. But with Zion, it's always good. So let's head on over to the corner where Zion is going to be telling us all about the newest Redstone sports and the best forecast weather in town, and what's being prepared for lunch and breakfast tomorrow. What's up, Zion?
Thanks, Laura. First off, today's wonderful news is brought to you and sponsored by Mancino's Pizza. And more delivered freshly to your door. Just call 936-2030. The 8th grade Redstone football team shut out Woodco 32-0. Jackson Lee, Blake Reed, Ezra Winkle, Tristan Sims all scored fabulous touchdowns. Cam Denny made all the extra points with some excellent kicking. Cole Filson had an interception that returned to a touchdown, but the penalty was on for the return and it made the touchdown not count. Also, Lincoln's 7th grade football team came out on top with a 22-0 victory. Seth Rundle, Blake Davis, and Cameron Van Loo all scored touchdowns. The Red Storm defense was strong last night, forcing 3 turnovers while getting the shutout. For breakfast tomorrow, we're going to have some yummy yogurt, cereal of your choice, fruit, and freshly squeezed juice. For lunch tomorrow, we see stuffed crust pizza, green beans straight from the garden, vegetables with ranch, and again, fresh fruit. Taking a look out on the weather window, it looks like old man winter is trying to knock down our door. We've had some pretty cold nights, and I think we may even dip into the 30s for lows in the next night or two. Better cover up those sensitive plants. As we head towards our lovely anchors, Haley and Laura, I'd like to thank our sponsors, Mancino's, once again for supporting us at what we do here at PTV2, serving us pretz, pizza, and more since the late 1930s. Now let's head back over to our fantastic anchors, Haley and Laura, to fill us in on today's trivia.
Thanks, Zion. It's Thursday. You know what that means. It's Trivia Thursday. And Mr. Hopple's back with us to share the trivia question for today. What do you have for today, Mr. Hopple?
Thanks, guys. I'm glad to be back here with today's trivia question. Today's question is for you iPhone people. Are you ready? Our question for today is, who are the male and female voices of Siri? Again, who are the male and female voices of Siri? Until today, I didn't know they were real people. Now I've learned something. If you know the answer, be sure to fill out the form on the Digital Storm website. If you're the first one with the correct answer, you win a box of candy. Okay, Haley and Laura, I'll let you take it from here. Thanks for letting me on the show again.
Thank you, Mr. Hopple. And don't forget, if you know the answer, send it on in on the Digital Storm website. We will not accept handwritten, Google Doc, or email answers. They must be submitted on the website. The winner of the prize? A delicious box of chocolates, and it will be announced at the end of the day.
Today we have some birthdays, and they are
Anna Qualicor and Mariana Diaz.
Happy birthday. Another big happy birthday wish from us to Corey Bano, Parker Gamble, Ayanna Soria, Dylan Boreas, Matthew Gerard, whose birthdays were over the weekend. Happy birthday, guys.
Are you guys Austin and Allie fans? Well, on an Austin and Allie episode, they talked about bullying. At the end of that episode, they had a public service announcement, or a PCA, that talks about bullying. During the PCA, the actors read mean comments about themselves to show that everyone can get bullied. And they tell you to trust your friends, family, and teachers to help you with bullying. If you're being bullied, don't be afraid to ask a friend, family member, or a teacher for support, because you're never alone.
All right, we've had a great show today. Let's wrap up what we've learned. Number one, don't forget to send any news you think deserves to be on the show by 9 a.m. We want your news.
Number two, if you have anything you'd like on the show or anything that you think needs fixed or any comments, make sure to contact us at lljxdigitalstorm.com.
The meeting for Washington, D.C. Trip Parent Meeting will be held Monday night, October 6th in the auditorium. Don't forget to go.
Number four, make sure to answer today's trivia question on the Digital Storm website for a chance to win big.
Remember that you're not alone. If you're having bullying problems, please make sure to tell someone because your life is worth more than what some people can say about you.
All right, so that about wraps up the show for today. But before we go, I'd like to thank our sponsor, Mancino's. Pizza the way you like it. I'm